Hey guys, and welcome back to Rogue Legacy. I'm Steejo, aka The Completionist, and we are 100% in Rogue Legacy. This is the final boss of our first playthrough of the game. Never fought him before, so let's go. We are in looks like a regular castle room. Well, a regular castle room that I don't think I've seen before. It's fucking massive. Oh, I thought I was going to fight the boss. Holy shit, that was a fucking level 71 Grey Knight. That Hokage can't one-hit kill. We do still have the place locked down, so all the gold that we get is getting severely chunked. But we'll just keep attacking everything to get loads of gold and hopefully get some health back. Down attack this. Ah, if you've been playing the game, if you've been watching me from the start, you'll know that this is the tutorial. That's what this is. That's how it's a massive room that I can't recall seeing before. Yep, I've already read all these. Oh wait, Journal Entry 25, today marks the rest of eternity. I never knew what treasure lay in this castle, just that it would cure the king of his illness. Who would have known it would have been the Fountain of Youth, a myth which grants one eternal life. As I look down on the body of the king, I realise that it's inevitable. Children will always answer for their father's sins. I entered this castle a swordsman, a saviour. But all I have left is a rogue's legacy. I can feel your anger. But no, it was not I who sent your family to ruin. The moment the king set foot within this castle, the royal coffers were emptied by Charon. My family, all families, had lost all hope for a better life. And in my mind's eye, I foresaw only desperation and poverty ravage the country. There was nothing left. There was nothing for me to go back to. To my children, and my children's children, here I sit, impassive, immortal, and await thee. Durr. Wow, so it turns out that Johannes, the very first person, doomed our entire family to... Why do you wish to fight me? How many sons and daughters have been lost in your pathetic attempts at revenge? I was the knight who... I was the king who brought your... fucking hell, Steejo, no brain. It was the king who brought ruin to your country, not I. He lied to us. He says he was wounded, yet it was only time that threatened him. He pitted his children against one another, sacrificed everything to satisfy his own selfish desires, and in the end, left his penniless and alone. So I took the only option left to me. I rejected king and country, and chose a new family instead. Zhum. The traitor, Johannes. Eep. Take retaliation. Oh my, how long do those things stay there? Please don't tell me they stay there forever. Fuck you, Johannes. You're gonna own me, you cunt. Aha! I am a Hokage. Of noble birth. Ehe. Fucking bad. Taking that a bit seriously, aren't you? Fuck. His health is so low. Died! God damn it. Yeah, it looks like a Hokage would probably be best for killing him. Or maybe even an assassin. A dwarfish assassin? No thanks. Bald tunnel vision Hokage? No thanks. We've got Lich Queen, Splunker. We've not played Archmage in ages. So let's go with an Archmage and we'll see if we can defeat Johannes with the Archmage. I probably should have went for attack damage. But whatever. Oh yeah, we've got this fucking epic sword that we could have got as well. Which is 1600 and 1700 actually. Oh well, never mind. Luckily, we don't need to lock down the castle at all. Ooh, I wonder what spells this guy's got. Axes, I think Fireball's probably the best one. I don't think we need to level up anymore. I think we've got a decent enough level for fighting Johannes. Yeah, we've already read this, Johannes. So, I don't know what level he is, but... Oh well, apparently not. Apparently he just absolutely destroys me, regardless of what skill I'm using. Let's try a bald spell sword. A fucking giant endomorph spelunker. I actually want to try this, because... I feel like being a giant, the size of this guy, being a giant endomorph will actually help us because he's got the knockback and he's got the massive sword, so I might actually be able to juggle Johannes. Come here so slow though. Yeah, yeah, Johannes, I don't care. Oing. Right. Nope. I was trying to get him stuck in that corner. Like, I think it's just too hard. I didn't actually check the level of him to see if we're a decent level. So blind the paladin who's colorblind, or dimp the archmage. No, I don't want a lich queen. A dwarfish spell sword. All right, let's try this. Maybe I'll need to like get some extra levels. Can't even defeat Johannes, Jesus Christ. Let's go. We've got Shakrams. So, as a spell sword, we should be able to do some extra lots of damage to him. Come here, Johannes. Oh! Ah, jumped right in his head. I'm trying to think, like, we're not really doing that well. I think the best that we've done was with a Hokage. I don't want to go a Lich Queen because Archmage, Barbarian Queen. We'll refresh them. Spell sort, Assassin. Oh, let's send an Assassin to an Assassin. We don't know what our health is though, which is a bit unsettling. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to change our cape to this one, which gives us extra chance and extra crit chance and extra damage. So we currently have a critical chance of 27 and crit damage of 300, so... and no health that we can actually see, which is really annoying. So hopefully with the ability to go invisible... Yeah, yeah, this is the annoying thing, man. I wish I could just, like, completely skip that out. The traitor, Johannes. So if I attack him and then go invisible, then... Shit, sorry guys, my fucking face is really itchy. Sorry for the lack of commentary, but... Oh my god! I don't know what health I had, and I thought he's really close to dying. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Right, Archmage, Lich King, Dragon, Muscle Weak, Eidetic Memory, yeah, let's try the Dragon. We've tried basically everything else, so we might as well give a Dragon a go. We've got fucking... Oh god, I really can't be bothered changing all the equipment round. Yeah, fuck it, we'll just go with this equipment. What can we go for? We don't need double jump, so we can put that on. We've no money to get any different ones. Haste run moves us faster. Alright, okay. Right, let's go, Chiron. Cheers. Take my 55 gold. We're going to fight Johannes. Why can't I skip this? Oh, Johannes is level 96, so we are higher level than Johannes. So, how we can't kill him, I've no idea. Ouch. Oh my god. Oh my god, I got hit by the fucking hilt of a sword. If we hide all the way up here. Nope. The dragon, I just don't like the dragon. The dragon's just not gonna cut it. We're just kinda bashing our face off it. If we can't defeat him in this episode. Paladin? A savant paladin? Let's go for the savant paladin. If we can't defeat him in this episode after bashing our head off against him all episode, then what we'll do is we will just... we'll go and try and get some more gold. Alright, get that, and that sorted. And we'll go on another gold farming run if we can't do it this time. Hopefully we can. Hopefully the paladin comes in handy, because we can just, the exact same as we was doing with the knight, we can just shield the knight with the, what's his face? Oh fuck, you little fuck. We've took a lot of damage already. Oh god man, this guy's so fucking difficult to kill. I suppose that's why he's the final boss. Oh my god, I was actually doing rather well there. I think I've got a new tactic for him. Paladin, Hokage, Muscle Weak Hokage, and Assassin. I want a Hokage, but not a Muscle Weak one. Ah, ADHD Hokage. Right, let's fucking do this. Hokages are a lot faster, so I should be able to, like, bash him and then dash back. Bash dash, bash and dash. The old bashy dash. This is a fucking fast Hokage. Right. He's got ADHD, so it makes him faster than normal, and he's a Hokage, which makes him faster than normal. So, what it does... there you go. Motherfucker. Oh fuck, run right into that. God damn it! God damn it, I can't fucking kill him! I am realising that I am bad at this game through fucking smashing my face off of this guy. A massive fucking assassin. Alright, let's try this. Yeah, I'm realising how bad I am at this game, fighting this guy. I don't know, I just... he's very tough. If you've got any strategies against Johannes, then please let me know. If there's any way to scum him, I'm not against it. I'm probably doing something terrible. I pushed Y, god damn it. There we go, killed him. Boom. Sorry for the lack of commentary there, I just thought I was doing that well. Alright, what happens now? You think you've slain me? Yes. I have. Fuck. I lived for over 1,000 years and I will live for 10,000 more. Alexander, Kedir, Ponce de Leon. I was not the first hero to reach a fountain, but I will be the last. There's a lot of health there. I was actually wondering that when I killed him and he dropped health. Oh, fuck. The fountain. Alright. Whoa! Wow, he gets knocked back, not. Okay, I need to take him a bit more carefully than the last guy. Whoa, what's he doing? God damn it, I wasn't expecting that. Right, so what we need is someone big. An assassin, it looks like. We need assassin or Hokage. We've got a lich, a spelunker, or a paladin. Let's go for the paladin, even though I don't think I'm going to do anything decent with him because he's got CIP and I hate CIP. So, we've managed to defeat Johannes once, but the fountain proved to be a bit more difficult. Blah blah blah. If we can get Endermorph. Then I think we'll be able to do a bit better. But so yeah, the way Johannes works is you just stand still and bash him. Although he has got a bigger sword. Actually, bow wow. I don't even know what my health is, so Yeah, okay, we read that last time. Ha 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 ha. The fountain. And the fountain requires a bit of skill. Oh, what? If I'd even thought that that was going to hit me, then... Why does he keep doing this? I don't like this. Oh wow. Well, I had low health there apparently. So yeah, maybe with the technique that we're using, the Barbarian King might work. As an assassin, Gigantism, Spell Sword, PAD. I don't want a Spell Sword. Hokage with PAD, Stereoblind Gay, Lich King, no thanks, and a Dragon. Nope, so we're going for the PAD Hokage. And we will swap the cape again, because I just realised that we've been using the other cape. So if we're using Hokage, we don't want to be using that cape. I actually think that we may be able to do it. I don't think it's that bad. I think my technique of just bashing and hoping for the best kind of works. Unless he uses his daggers, then he does damage, but... fuck's sake. Right. My god! Hokages just don't work for that, apparently. Right. We might be able to get one more. Assassin, Hypochondriac, Ectomorph. No. We're looking for an Endomorph. And if we don't get an Endomorph, we'll just pick one. Assassins seem to be the guys that we have the best luck with. Yeah, so we're looking for Endomorphs, and if we can't get one, we'll pick like an assassin or something like that. And I really think that we've got the levels to do it. We just don't have the skill to do this guy just now. If he didn't attack like straight away, like if he done an attack like the fountain, where he basically, oh fuck, he's gonna kill me. I fucking do it. He's just so fast that I can't seem to work out exactly what we need to do. Hypergonadism Spelunker. Ah, there we go, Hypergonadism Barbarian Queen. That's even better. I was kind of hoping for a barbarian queen because I was like, yeah, if we get a barbarian queen, that means that we've got a barbarian, that means we've got a lot of experience, a lot of health. We will do this last run because I think this seems like the most promising combination of class of skills and stuff. So we'll do this one and then we'll call it an episode because we are at the 20-minute mark. Right, so whenever he comes at us, we'll just smack him, and it'll smack him away. Ah! Prick. Come on, Johannes. Just take it easy, nice and easy. We'll just wait on him. You son of a bitch. Excuse me? Excuse me? Foos! Fuck off, I like. There we go. Ah, oh, motherfucker, I hate it when he does that. He just stands so close to you and then does that. You've got no bloody chance to dodge it. There we go. Wow, what a dick. Yeah! Sorry for the lack in commentary there, but as you know, this is it's a bit harrowing. So we're almost there, come on. This guy's a bit more difficult to do, and I don't think he gets knocked back at all, so yeah, an endermoth doesn't really help us. No. Oh, that was really helpful. Yeah, I should probably be saving that. I should probably be saving my mana for when he does the sidey wall thing. The sidey wall thing? The dagger thing in the wall. Oh, apparently I've run out of mana already. There we go, so whenever he does that, he can just jump onto one of them. Whenever he does that, it's pretty easy. You should just look out on the floor for that space. Except for when he fucking runs towards you. What? Oh man, I should have used right trigger. That was so fucking close. So fucking close. Ah, who are we going to try next? Should we go for a Lich Queen? Hyper Gonad is a Lich Queen, I suppose. Savant, Baldness, Spelunker. Oh man, we've got another giant. We've got a giant Barbarian King. Right, so next episode we're going to try and defeat Johannes again as the giant Barbarian King. But thanks a lot for watching as always, guys. Sorry I couldn't defeat the boss. This has just been like a boss grindy episode, this episode. But yeah, I hope you join me next time where hopefully we can finish him off and kill the fucker. So thanks a lot for watching and I will see you next time.